What is the stock history function in Microsoft Excel 365? The stock history function retrieves historical data about a stock or share. The data is loaded as an array. Excel will dynamically create the appropriate sized array range when you press enter. Now, the syntax of the stock history function is as follows. The stock name and the stock exchange. And if you don't talk about the stock exchange, it will take the default stock exchange, which could be, for example, NASDAQ. The start date from which you want to get the data and the end date. Interval is whether you want to get the data daily, weekly, or monthly. Headers is like, for example, name of the stock, the closing price, the opening price, and so on. Then you have five properties which indicate, for example, things like volume purchased, closing price, opening price, and so on. Here you can see that the stock argument is the ticker symbol that you have to provide. For example, for Microsoft, you'll provide MSFT, or a reference to a cell containing the stocks data type. Now, this will pull data from the default exchange for the instrument. We can also refer to a specific exchange by entering a 4-character ISO market identifier code, in short MIC, followed by a colon, followed by the ticker symbol. Example, for the NASDAQ, we would write XNAS:MSFT and quotes close. So quotes open and quotes close. Or for example, for the Nifty exchange in India, you would write XNSE: and the ticker symbol. For example, Cipla. Now, where do you get these abbreviations? Well, you can get these abbreviations on different websites. I will give you also a link in the description. So let's talk about the various arguments. Start date, the earliest date for which data is retrieved. So you have to enter the data in quotes. You can also enter it as a formula like today, or you can take a cell reference to a cell with a date. The end date argument is optional. The latest date for which data will be retrieved. Interval is, for example, whether you want to get the data on a daily basis, weekly, monthly, and so on, and the default is zero. Headers, it's also optional, specifies whether to display headings as follows: 0, no headers; 1, show headers; 2, show instrument identifier and headers. Default is 1. When included, headers are rows of text that are part of the array returned from the function. For example, you could have the header date, close, open, and so on. Now, the properties 0 to 5 arguments are also optional. The columns that are retrieved for each stock are as follows: 0 is date, 1 is close, 2 is open, and so on. If any of them is present, only the indicated columns are returned in the order provided. Now, you can see the definition of the properties here for the date, close, open, high, low, volume. For example, volume is volume traded during the period. How do you enter the property arguments? When we enter the property arguments, we type a number for each property 0 through 5 in the order you want to see them. The value we enter for each property corresponds to the property number. For example, to include date, open, and close, we would enter 0, 2, and 1. Now, let us have a look at an example in Microsoft Excel. So now we are back into the Excel worksheet, and let us see how we can use the stock history function to get the data of a specific stock. So we will write here equal to stock, and you see here you get stock history And the first parameter that you have to give is the stock. So in quotes, I will give the stock exchange, that is NASDAQ colon, and let me take MSFT, Microsoft, as the name. Then the start date, I'll put a start date in quotes, for example, MMDD, and the year, let's say 2020 or 2021. That will be our start date, comma. Then now we have to give an end date. This is optional. So we'll give an end date. For example, this is the MM, so DD, and the year 2021, quotes close. Then we have to give the interval. So how do we want it? Daily, weekly, or monthly? So let us say we want it daily. So we'll write zero here, comma. And now we need to specify whether we wish to have the headers like date, the opening price, closing price, and so on. So we can say show header, but we can also say show instrument identifier and header. That means it will also show us the stock exchange and the sticker symbol, okay, which is 2. So I'll write 2, or I could have pressed the tab key, comma. And what are the properties you wish to have? Do you wish to have the date, closing price, opening price, and so on? So I'll say, okay, I want date, so 0, then comma, properties 2. So I'll say I want the, let's say, opening price. I'll press the tab key, then I want the closing price, that is 1. So I'm putting it in the order I want, okay? So let's say I want it in this case volume, so I'll press the tab key. So the properties have been done, and I'll just close the brackets and press enter. So it shows you busy, and then it gets you the data, so you can expand the columns to get the data, and you have the data right from 4th January to 1st February. Now, what if you wanted the same data from the stock exchange, the National Stock Exchange of India, NSE? So you would write equal to stock history, and in quotes we will write X NSE colon, and we will write, for example, Cipla, as I showed you in the presentation, quotes close. This is a pharmaceutical company. So we will write the date. Again, we will write, for example, 1st January 2021, quotes close, and we will take the end date as, let's say, February, that is 02, and the year is 2021, quotes closed. Now, what is the interval I want to have the data? So daily, I'll press the tab key. Then the headers, do I want the headers? Yes, I want the headers with the instrument, like you saw here. It shows here NASDAQ and Microsoft. So I want that also. Then let's say properties, I want the date. Then I want the opening price, comma. I'll take the closing price also, comma. I want the high, comma. I want the low also, and the volume traded. And brackets close and press enter. So it shows busy, and then you see you get the data here. I'm just auto fitting. So you see you have all the data here with the date, the opening price, the closing price, the high, the low, and the volume traded. I hope you found this interesting and useful. Thanks for watching.